In this figure, given that O is the center of circle and two angles are given, angle OAB is 30 degree and angle OCB is 40 degree, and we need to find out the angle AOC. Now, to solve this problem, we'll start with the radius of circle. OA is the radius of circle because O is center and A is the point on the circumference of circle. Similarly, OC is also a radius of circle. Now we will draw a line from the center to point B on the circumference, and this OB is also a radius of circle. Now in triangle AOB, the two sides are equal. OA is equal to OB because both are the radius. It means this triangle AOB is an isosceles triangle, and we know that in isosceles triangle the opposite angles are equal. So angle OAB is equal to angle OBA. OBA is also 30 degree. We have another triangle COB. In this triangle, two sides are equal. OC and OB are equal because they are the radius. It means this triangle is also isosceles triangle, and in isosceles triangle opposite angles are equal. So if angle OCB is 40 degree, then angle OBC is also 40 degree. Now we know that the angle subtended by an arc on the circumference of circle is half of the angle subtended by the same arc on the center of circle. At the center, arc AC is subtending angle AOC, and at the circumference, arc AC is subtending angle ABC. So angle ABC is half of angle AOC. Now what is angle ABC? Angle ABC is sum of angle ABO and angle CBO. ABC is angle OBA plus angle OBC. So AOC is now twice of 30 degree plus 40 degree. So twice of 70 degrees, 140 degree. Hence the angle AOC is 140 degree.